screened-in porch like this, you've probably considered enclosing it so you can spend more time outside in winter. Now, when I discovered a professional would charge me $1,500 to do this, I decided I could definitely do this project myself and save some money. However, this is not a project you can do in one afternoon. I probably spent about 25 hours working on this, and I paid about $220 to $230 for the materials. Finally, I should add that I'm not an expert and I don't claim any special expertise, but I'm hoping that this video will at least inspire you to try to enclose your own porch. But I'd like to start by showing you an example of a vinyl cover that I've already made. This is made from clear plastic vinyl. I think it's the 20 gauge or 20 gauge. I purchased this online from a fabric store called fabric.com. And as you can see, what I'm using around the edges is, it's basically duct tape. It's a high grade duct tape. It's called Pro Gaff. It comes in all different colors. It's fairly expensive, but I like this because it really has a nicer quality feel than regular duct tape. Also, it's sticky, but it doesn't leave a residue behind, and you can peel it off of things easily. So, basic materials that I'm using are this 20 gauge or 20 gauge clear plastic vinyl, the ProGaff duct tape, which also I purchased online from a company called tapebrothers.com, and then I'm using these brass grommets that you can see here, and this is how I'm making the covers. So, a review of the materials that you'll need for this project. First of all, you'll need a tape measure to measure your porch. The next thing you'll need is a straight edge so that you can mark the vinyl, and some scissors to cut it with. It's fairly easy to cut, so just a regular pair of scissors will work fine. The next thing you need is the grommet tool, which I'll explain about more later, and also the grommets and a hammer. And finally, to hang the covers when you've made them, I'm going to use deck screws. I think they're 1.5 or 1.25 deck screws and a screwdriver. So before you cut the plastic, first of all, you need to measure. I like the panels to be centered on the posts, so you need to measure from the front side of one post to the front side of the next post. So in this case, it's 8 foot, let's say 1/2 inch. But you also need to add an extra inch to allow for the panels to overlap. So this is the vinyl that I'm using. As you can see, it comes on a roll, and it comes with paper backing. So you've got the vinyl, and then behind the vinyl, you've got this tissue paper backing. As you can see, I'm working on the floor here, so I decided to leave the tissue backing in place. So that it helps to keep the vinyl clean. So the first thing you need to do is just roll it out. Okay, so the first thing I'm doing is I'm measuring the vinyl, and as you can see, I've put a tape measure on one end, and I'm measuring it down here at what I need is 94 1/4. So I've got the tape measure stretched out. I'm making a mark here. And I've actually already done the same thing on the other side. So the next thing I need to do is just to draw a straight line. So the really nice thing about this vinyl is it's very easy to cut. You could probably do this with a utility knife, but I find it pretty easy to do with the scissors. And I'm cutting through the vinyl and also through the paper underneath the vinyl. Okay, so once again, using the scissors, just trying to cut this long straight line. Don't forget, measure twice and cut once. The next step after you've cut the vinyl is actually the trickiest part, and that is putting the tape on the edges. Alright, so the first thing is to pull it out. Takes a bit of effort. Further, another foot. Okay, so once you've got the tape pulled out, you need to lay it on the floor I just do it just along the edge of the vinyl, and then you're going to lift up the vinyl. Again, you really need two people to do this. And you're going to position the vinyl just under the edge and try and get it so that it is exactly halfway under. It's really tricky to do and fiddly, and you may have to pick it up and peel it back and do it again. That's too cold. Okay, that's better. All right, so that is about right. So for folding over the top, I like to start in the middle and work my way toward the edge. So just grab it, fold it down, smooth it out. It may not be absolutely perfect, but hopefully it'll be good enough. Just keep folding all the way down. Try and work out any creases that you get. And when you get to the end, you can just trim it flush. And then you're going to do the same thing with all of the edges. So you want tape like this around every edge. Once you have the tape all the way around the edges, the next thing you need to do is put the grommets in. And for this, you need to use a grommet tool. Now, I purchased this at Lowe's or Home Depot. It only cost about $8 or $9, and it's pretty easy to use. Basically, there are three pieces. There's this little piece that you use to cut the hole, and then there are these two pieces that you use to put the grommet in. The grommets themselves come in two parts. There's a part where the middle sticks up, and there's another part which fits down on top of it. Also, there are two kinds of grommets I've found. These ones, the first ones I was using, the part which fits down is just like a smooth disc. And some other ones I was using, the part that fits down actually has some little spikes that stick up. So I think I'll show you how to use this one. The grommet tool also comes with a piece of hardwood for you to hammer onto. It was about twice this size, but I hammered a little too hard and I broke it in half, and then my dog carried away the other half. But this half works fine. So, show you how to make the holes. You know you're going to need holes in the corners, so I'm going to start with a corner here. First thing is to put the piece of wood underneath the corner. Center the grommet tool right in the corner there. Make sure you have the sharp edge pointing down. Then you're going to give it several whacks with a hammer. Hopefully that should be enough to cut through. As you can see, it made a hole all the way through. I think I should just be able to pull this little bit out. If not, I'll just give it a couple more whacks. Okay, so there you have the hole. As you can see, that was pretty easy. Next step is to put the grommet in. So, you start with the part of the grommet which has a piece that points up, and you put that underneath and you poke it up through the hole. So now you can see that little piece is poking up through the hole. Then you take this part, which has a kind of concave disc in the top, put that underneath. You take the next piece, and you use this so that it fits down in the top, and the little spikes should be pointing up. Finally, you take this piece of the grommet tool, you put it in the top, so you see you've got the bottom piece, you've got the bottom grommet, you've got the plastic, the top grommet, and then the tool. And give it about 4 or 5 whacks with a hammer. And as you can see, that's enough to fix the grommet firmly in place. last set of holes are marked. Just need to cut the holes and put the grommets in.
So the final step is actually installing the vinyl on the outside of the screen. You could do it on the inside. I chose to do it on the outside because it's much less visible from inside the porch that way. So I have the piece of vinyl rolled up here. I'm going to start by, I've marked where it needs to go, and I'm going to start by just putting a screw through the final grommet. So now I'm just going to roll the piece of vinyl all the way to the next post and pull it taut and put a screw in the other end. So this is how the finished porch looks from the outside. As you can see, we put our Christmas lights up at the same time.